One of the joys of modern telecommunications. Long ago I set up a LAN infrastructure here based around a Divino router with a USB modem in it, cabled to a couple of Yagi antenna pointed to the cell tower 4 or 5 kilometres away. And at one stage I was able to get 15 megabit per second download speed on that, which is pretty flash, I thought. It's working in now, says it's 4G, says it's 80% signal strength, but I'm getting less than 2 megabit per second download speed at about 3 or 4 upload, which is confusing. So, got to do better than that. Then, the alternative here is that on the side of the house, there's a commercial hotspot, which has got a cable running away over the house. And into the distance, I'd like to try and see where that cable goes. But given that they can get a cable for Ethernet here to that commercial hotspot, I figure there's got to be a way to get cable for me to my router. So I'm going to have to look into that. So that's one thing on the agenda. The other thing is we've got local SIMs for our phones. I've got a dual SIM phone that has my amazing from Australia in it, which is roaming, and I've got the data turned off obviously, but I can make phone calls on that at $1 per minute and send SMSs at 50 cents a time. It's roaming to the telecom cell network, and I've got 4, sometimes 5 bars of signal strength. Fine. So the other SIM that we put in, passing the vendors. The other SIM that's in it is actually a telecom cell SIM. So it's seen 4, sometimes 5 bars of signal strength. But when I try to use it for making a call or sending an SMS, it basically says, nah, no network available. So I think there must be some sort of registration process that needs to be done for the SIM on the network to say yes, you'll accept connections from that. But you can't get good help. Jabida's phone's in the same situation with the telecom cell SIM in it, and took it into Panambang, and of course the helpful person in the shop there says, oh, Australian phone, no good. Which prompts me to think, okay, Jabida, you should have gone to a different shop because that person obviously has no idea whatsoever what they're talking about. So at the moment, I can be called on my Australian number, but my Indonesian number just does not compute, does not work at all, which is a concern because I put our Indonesian numbers on the application form for my ETAS visa on Monday. And I'm a bit concerned now that if they try to call me, they're not going to get a response. They've got my email and Santa, my brother-in-law's email, on their forms, and in my sort of concerned state, I suggested to Santa that perhaps he should give them a call and give them his number in case they have any questions related to the form and application. But given that it's currently Thursday, and they're usually 2 or 3 days to process those forms, I start to wonder what's the holdup. I've got until the 16th to get that form sorted out. It's currently the 9th, so a week. A bit concerned. What happens if I don't get that ETAS before the 16th of December? Whether I have to go back to Australia or I have no home to go to. We live in interesting times. I guess I'll find out. The paperwork has a lot of over here. I'm sure there'll be many, many more frustrations as time goes by. Fortunately, I'm a fairly calm guy. upset about things, but